same loop. 15 chapter, starting at the 11th verse. Now, if I don't preach this thing tonight, then I got my brother here. I got two sons here. I got my wife here.
Yeah.
I got my other two sons from another mother here.
So
I got Ella Reese here, and I got Mother Reese. Some of y'all can preach it if I can't preach it tonight.
Hallelujah.
Is that all right, Ella
Reese?
No.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Y'all got it.
Amen.
Ella's gonna do the reading for the mother.
Okay.
She got on the cheek. Talking with eyes still. Amen. Start it off reading.
And he said. A certain man. Had two sons.
Had two sons. Yeah, hold on, give him time to find it. Yeah, you just talk. All right, don't worry about it. You just hang on with us. Praise the Lord. A certain man had two sons.
Yes, sir.
Well, thank God I had three sons.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Yes, all right.
I had three sons and a daughter. Praise the Lord. It's getting kind of crowded in the house tonight. Praise the Lord. See my little great-granddaughter here.
Right.
Y'all, I just keep on getting them. Ella,
yes,
I'm going to mess around and shout in a minute.
Right.
Thank you. Hallelujah.
Yes,
y'all, man, don't do this to the old man. Praise the Lord. Read, man.
12th verse. And the younger of them said.
And the younger son said.
To his father. Father.
Father.
Give me the portion. Of goods.
Now, I know that all of us has one time or another said unto your parents, I think I'm grown. I don't need to live by your rules anymore. I just need you to give me what's mine. Because I'm going to go out spurring on the town. Praise the Lord. And just, I can imagine being a parent. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And having some sons and a daughter. I got some witnesses here, so I'm preaching to y'all and I preach to them. Is that what y'all say?
Help yourself, Chief.
Why y'all put me in a trick like this tonight?
Help yourself, Chief.
But I guess I got to go on, run on and see what the end gonna be.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And they'll come and say, listen, your rules is pretty stiff, old man.
Oh, watch it now.
And I think I'm grown enough to get out on my own. Mother, you ain't gonna talk to me tonight.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. And all I could say was to them, I'll give you what I have to give you. I think you ought to hang around the whole place, but if you feel that you're old enough, you're grown enough to get on your own, I'm gonna try and advise you the proper way and the proper thing to do. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
First thing, don't go to the streets running wild. All right. Get yourself a job and become somebody. Oh, somebody say amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. And I can imagine, praise the Lord, the things that I was saying to them at that time were not a part of what they wanted to hear.
Come on.
So they went on off in the screen, and the scripture says what?
Amen. He went on to say and say, Father.
Father.
Give me the portion of goods.
Give me the portion of goods.
That falleth to me.
That falleth to him.
And he divided unto them. His living.
Not the one. But he divided unto them.
Amen.
His what?
Living.
His living. Come on.
And not many days after.
Now y'all listen to this. Not many days after what happened?
The younger son gathered all his belongings. And took his journey.
To a far country. See, I'm preaching this tonight not because I picked it, but because God is the one to give it to me.
Thank you.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
See, Mother, if I can preach it to your children, I can preach it to mine.
Amen.
All right, Ella. And I ain't going around the bush to come in the back door. Well, I'm coming down Broadway. Should I say, let me say that, I'm coming down Straight Street. Are y'all able to say that? I got away from Crook Avenue when I was talking about your children. So now I got to come down Straight Street. Talk to me.
In there.
Come on.
Wasted his substance.
The younger son took his substance and he wasted it. Hey, y'all, if anybody in here know what I'm talking about, if you don't want to say amen, just grunt
for me. Bishop.
Thank you. Praise the Lord. And I'm going to have to look over at you and see whether you're asleep or not.
All right.
Or somebody ought to say amen.
Amen.
See, I know the issues is here because I'm here.
All right.
Bishop,
yes, sir.
I've been there, done that, been a part of that. Are y'all able to talk
to me? Amen.
Even when so far I've become a great grandpa.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Don't you stop preaching back then.
Thank you, Jesus.
Or somebody ought to say amen.
Amen.
Mama, this is a hot stuff here tonight.
Come on.
But you, don't you.
In there.
Wasted
his substance.
Wasted his substance.
With riotous living.
Come on.
And when he had spent all. There arose. A mighty famine.
In the land. Come on.
And he began to be in want. And he went and joined himself to a citizen of that country.
Which means he done run out of money. He ain't got no more money. So he went and joined this group. Just to get something to eat.
Amen.
But in joining the group, they didn't have any money to give him. Praise the Lord. So but they did give him some information where to go and get some work.
Amen.
Come on, read.
And he sent him into his fields to feed swine.
Oh, glory to God. Let me see the hands of you to know what pigs is. Sent him down to feed the pigs.
Yes, sir.
And as he went down to feed the pigs, praise the Lord, he was a very hungry brother. And since he couldn't get any money, and the closest thing he could get to food was a hog slop, he kneeled to eat out the hog pen himself. Go ahead and read the rest of it, because we're going home with that.
That's all right, Chief. And he would fain have filled his belly with the husk that the swine did eat. And no man gave unto him. And when he came to himself, he said,
How many hired servants have my father got? Which means there's much for you to eat at home. You don't have to eat at the home, man.
Well,
you don't have to be a slave in the streets. You don't have to have somebody looking down on you.
Yeah.
You don't have to wonder, can you make it or not?
Well,
God has guaranteed us a waymaker.
Amen.
I'm going to read this question up so we go on.
How many hired servants of my father's have bread enough and to spare and I perish with hunger? I will rise.
And go.
To my father. And I will say unto him, Father.
Y'all read it when you get home.
Amen.
Read the rest when you get home. Look at somebody and tell them, one more night in the hog pen and I'm going home.
One more night in the hog pen and I'm going home.
Now look at somebody on the other side and say, this is the last night.
This is the last night.
I'm going to be seen at the hog pen.
I'm going to be seen at the hog pen.
Well, I'm going home. Hey, glory. Somebody ought to say amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. If you ain't never been there, Bishop, you don't know how it feels. But I've been down to the hog pen, but I ain't going no more. Well, somebody ought to say amen.
Amen.
I'm asking too many to go down there, but I'm telling them, for being that sight, they ain't going no more. Oh, somebody ought to say amen.
Amen.
Somebody need to say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I found my friend and asked them if they could feed, if they could give me a little bit to eat, and they said, I don't have any. I had some enemies, praise the Lord, looked at me and said, I know that he would be down here soon, praise the Lord. But I stopped by to let you know tonight, I'm going home tonight, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I'm no longer in that field feeding the horse. I'm no longer looking down the road. I heard my dad say, praise the Lord, son, come home.
All right, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Well, well.
I got my son in the house. I got my grandson in the house. Praise the Lord. I got my friends in the house. Do y'all mind if I just, I got my brother in the house. Do y'all mind if I preach it just a little bit?
It's
a
preach.
I promise y'all let you hold up and get you the grace. Praise the
Lord. Go ahead, boss.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord, and he got a little jealous, and the older son said, hey, Dad, I got to talk to you. We got to have a little talk now. There's something wrong with this here. Praise the Lord. Now, I've been with you all the time. Praise the Lord. I ain't never left you. And never let you work by yourself. Praise the Lord. And you ain't never give me no party. Praise the Lord. But the son that just been come home. Praise the Lord. And you want me to kill the patty. You want me to take your robe and put your only robe on him. My ring priest, the family ring priest, Lord, needs to be identified. Now, I want to know, praise the Lord, what's the difference in him and I? The father looked at him and put his arm around his neck and said, my son, my son, you've never been lost. Praise the Lord. But he lost, and now he's found, and it's time.
It's been too
same, mother.
I was raised to death.
Mama, I was afraid to leave here.
Because
I had to have all my kids in one place.
So I could
rejoice on Jesus' side.
Yes, Jesus.
Come on, say it. Come on. Say it.
It's been a long time coming, but I know.
Hey, I was Jeffro. Little Jeffro, Joe. Can you hit it one time? Come on, don't let me down, son. Took me too long to hit it. I would ask Jeff to sing it, but he the police and they come lock him up. Come on, get it out of hand. You may have some people tonight, praise the Lord, that say you ain't nothing, ain't gonna be nothing, never was nothing, praise the Lord. But you need to stand up and tell them tonight. I might not have been nothing yesterday. But God knows, look at me today.
Right.
I am somebody in Jesus Christ.
Yes, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Maybe I couldn't preach yesterday.
Uh-huh.
But mother, you know what? I believe I can preach today.
Right.
Ella?
Yes, sir.
I hear you. So, I believe, Ella.
Yes, sir.
Even if you got to go ahead and take this information across the town, tell them, say, yesterday,
yes,
he was a prodigal son.
Yes, sir.
But I was there tonight.
Yes, sir.
When he came home and they put the ring and the robe on his finger.
Yes, sir.
And told him that he was back in the royal family.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
God, glory.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I don't mind waiting. I don't mind waiting. I don't mind waiting. Oh, I don't mind waiting on the Lord. Hey, see, when you wait on God, let me see your hands in here that feel like you might have one time enough waited on the Lord.
Glory, yes, sir.
Yes, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Everything don't come when you think it ought to come.
Yes, sir.
Everything does not come because you need something. The book of Ecclesiastes picked it up and said there's a time and there is a place and there's a season. If you don't mind, if you just don't mind, don't mind waiting.
Don't mind waiting.
It's all right, you.
All right. Hallelujah.
Let us begin to wait on God. Many times we are in places or doing things that we think that God loves and likes, but not so. It's because it's what you like.
Amen.
It's what you want. But you say, now wait a minute. If I'm doing what this is in the Bible, why don't God like it? Because he didn't tell you to do it. See, God told you to go up the road. Because you looked backwards and seen down the road was a faster way, you went down the road.
Amen.
God didn't bless you going down the road. Now you start having problems and issues. Lord, I'm serving you. No, you're serving you. You're not serving God. When you're serving God, it doesn't matter how high the hill look. You know that God got the power to carry you over. It doesn't matter when God is in control. It doesn't matter what the situation look like.
That's right.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
It doesn't matter how many friends you haven't got. It really doesn't matter, bro, how many friends you got. Praise the Lord. It means that if you got Jesus on your team, you got to do it. All you got to do is just walk on this way.
All right.
Yes, sir.
Huh?